It's a type of contract where you know how much is going to be delivered on which date. Whereas for contracts, it's like you have made an agreement, but you are not very sure when these things will come up. So we are now into the customer master. He has seen that there is only one sole to party. Okay. But sometimes it happens like, as a head office, I am negotiating on behalf of all my stores. Okay. And I am signing up the contract with your vendor. And I want, it's not like, that doesn't mean I have to create the sales orders. Okay. I am the head office and I don't have much interference, I mean, involvement in the day-to-day business or procurement. So I want the store to take care of the contract release orders or something. So I want to add them also so that they can release orders on their reference in this contract. But in the partner function, we can have only one sole to party. For addressing this scenario, SAP has come up with the partner function called as AA, that is the contract release for sold to party for contract release. So let me say I authorize S62A02. So if I make a contract, I can authorize 2, 3, A02, A03, A04, and A05 also to release the same contract. Okay. So here I have made it. Similarly, I want to add the ship to party with reference to the contract. So AWS 4 AWS 5. So when you make a contract, so what are the things you can agree for? When you make a contract, let me say, like, I am entering into a contract with my vendor. What are the things I will be looking at? Okay. But in contract, I don't have delivery dates. I just say, like, I want this goods for so and so quantity for next year. That's it. I don't give the delivery dates in contract. But when you sign up a contract, you look for special prices, okay? You look for an assurance, okay, that I have entered into contract. He will honor the contract and I will be assured of this much of goods delivered next year. Okay? So that kind of assurance is there. When you enter into a contract, like, you can enter either for quantity or the value, which means you can say, I will buy so and so quantity of goods for the next year. That's what you say when you enter into a quantity contract. So here you specify in terms of quantity. And there is something called as value contract. In the value contract, you assure your customer that you will give so and so worth of business. I will give you, let me say, $100,000 worth of business. When you say $100,000 worth of business, you can even narrow down, or you can stipulate, okay, that $100,000 will be taken up by selling only these articles and services. So you can group the set of articles and say, whatever is taken from this group of articles, that only is valid for your value contract. So there are two things we have seen. One is the value contract and another one is the quantity contract. So we have the document type WK1 and WK2 corresponding to the value quantity as well as the value contract. So let me go to the contract, create WK1. WK1 is the value contract. So when I say value contract, so I am saying here you can see the there is a target value. There is no item. You don't enter any items here. Okay. But there are two ways of specifying what articles you have to handle in this particular contract. Okay. One is the assortment module. What is an assortment basically? So when you go to assorted pack, assorted within, especially in the supermarket you can find out this assorted pack. What is an assortment or assorted pack? Different variety of goods grouped together, packed together. Okay, the same thing. I have to create an assortment module saying that these are all the articles that can be contained in this module. So whenever somebody makes a sales order referencing to that contract, so they will be choosing the material from that module. Okay, so before creating the value contract, we have to group the things you want to offer in that particular contract. Okay, so I go to master data, conditions, sorry, product, master data, product, assortment, module. Assortment is purely a IS retail concept, okay, but only touch point between the IS retail functionality and SD is this contract, where I have to choose what is the value contract type. Okay. So this contract is starting from today and it is up to the end of this year. The assortment module. So what are all the articles? 80101. Choose 121 because we don't use that material mostly. So T-AT122. T-AT123. So these are all the articles I am going to use in my assortment module. Let me copy this number first. Okay. I am saving it. Now I go to the value contract where I am creating the master data sales contract create. Enter the value contract. Value contract valid from today to. See, since I have the so much of contract release sold to parties, I can choose whether I want to authorize somebody to carry out this contract or I can make myself successor sold to party and then process. So my value is, so each article costs 400 approximately. So let me say 40,000. I assign this module to the contract. Okay. If you are not handling the assortment module, there is another option. Okay. There is something called as product hierarchy. You remember in the Metal Master we have seen the product hierarchy. You say like you group the article under certain hierarchy. First you say computers. Within the computer we have so many parts. Okay. One of them is the hard drive. So inside the hard drive you come to computers. Hard drive, inside the hard drive you have something else like based on the memory or something. Okay. So you can either choose the product, which means like you can choose all the computer products or you can choose all the computer drive based products. Okay, and everything. And there is something here called as material, that is the value contract material. This is very similar to the settlement material which we saw in the rebate, which means when you are creating the value, sales document, okay, you might want some material for settlement, as a settlement article. So you use the settlement article type WKM1. So meanwhile, before proceeding into the business procedure, we will see the configuration of this document, okay, VOV8. WKM1, that is my value contract. I had assigned the outline agreement messages. Okay, pretty much similar. Okay. Here it is just a contract, which means like it is just an agreement. So there is no credit check or no credit limit checking. Okay. Only the credit limit checking are done for the release order. Okay, that is referenced from this contract. So as per contract, you don't have any credit limits. And let us go to the item category class in VOV7. What is this item category? WKN. WKN is the value contract item. So I go to WKN. In the contract, you come across this concept called as completion rule. Okay, completion rule says, do you remember the completion rule with your documents? We had seen this completion rule previously in the document. I say that I am creating inquiry for 50 pieces. I create a quotation for only 40 pieces. If you go to the document flow, still you can see the status of the inquiry has closed, even though the full quantity is not referenced, because the item category AGM is set in such way. So here we can see item is completed with the first reference irrespective of the quantity. Okay. Then you have something called as full quantity is referenced, okay, or full target quantity is referenced. Okay. So based on this only the system will determine whether your contract is completely referenced or not. For example, you had made a contract for 100 pieces, up to 99 pieces it won't give any messages or warning. If you are crossing that 100 thing, the system will give you a warning saying that you are exceeding the agreed contract level, whether you want to continue or edit. Okay. So if you want to get those kind of messages, I told you that it has to be first done in the document type. So class N VOV8. Okay. In that outline agreement message we had seen WK1. This is the outline agreement message. Okay. One is B. We have told the system has to check for the header and item combination. Okay. And second one is whether it has to check for the relief partner. So we have created the relief partners for this AA and AW. Okay, that is contract relief sold to party as well as the contract relief shipped to party. Okay. So whether you want to generate or add contact for partners authorized to relief in center level. Okay. These are all the configurations. Okay. So I go to here. I save it. To contact 440205 has been here. Right. Now I have created a contract. Whenever I create a sales order, okay, the subsequent document are called as either release orders or blanket orders. So which means whenever I create sales orders, I reference this particular contract and I make the orders, delivery, etc. Okay. So now I go to contract, document type is OR. Create with reference, go to contract 440205. The system says there are more than one third party who are authorized to release this contract. So let me choose this third party 01. Similarly goes for the fifth party also. Here it comes to the screen. Here from here you have to choose the which articles you are going to include in your release order or follow up sales order. Select that assortment, expand the assortment. Inside the assortment you have the goods which you have defined for this particular contract. So let me say 10, 5 and another 10. Okay. Go back, copy. The system will copy this material into this thing. You have maintained the prices. Nobody touches this article. Yeah, 00. So let me say 400. I have created. So let me create another sales order. Okay. I am not referencing anything. Okay. Value contract T-AT 1-1 20 pieces. After entering the sales order, somebody reminds me, hey, like there is a contract already existing for that material. So why you want to go for a normal sales order? I mean, you can use the contract facility. Okay. So sometimes it happens that somebody says, okay, let me save the sales order. Okay. After saving, somebody comes and reminds me, hey, like we have already a contract existing for that. Okay. You could have utilized that contract, so why you are going for out of contract settlement? So you can always assign the contract to a particular item or for a customer header level at a later time, which means before carrying out the further document you will be able to assign the contract. Okay. So okay, before that let us complete the previous cycle slash OVL01N minus 1102, because I want to variable sometimes this will give you error, like this is a abath error when you are trying to carry out the picking and posting together. Yesterday I got that error many times last night. It will say that SQL data is too much for the database. Caching VM02N possible issue. Let the carry be possible to show. Session year 01. Let us go to the contract and see that. Before that, let me delete this newly created page order. So currently being possible to use. 93. Okay, slash NVA 42 this is my contract. So I had agreed for the target value of 10,000 and I have processed the value release of 40,000 I have agreed, out of which I have released 10,000. Okay. Now let me create another sales order without referencing the contract. VA01OR. This is my customer. And let me say this is the material. Empty pieces. Okay. AR00. I save it also. Okay. Then somebody says like, hey, we have the contract existing for that, so why can't you utilize that? We are not using that much. Okay. Then even after before creating the delivery, I will be able to assign the contract to any item or header level. Okay. So let me choose the item. I go to edit, assign contract to item, because SAP itself suggests that you assign the contract to the item level so that it can update your contract. So I assign, so what is the it is for that particular sales order. Which one do you think? Yeah, we will see that. We will see that configuration also. Okay. So, I have selected the contract for this and I have assigned the contract to this item at the later time. We cross whether my contract is open. So today another lesson is you cannot process a document. Another document when the main document is open. I was trying to do some changes with the material is on. I was trying to assign a contract with the contract on, but it gives me a message saying that this document is being processed currently. Okay. So you can see contract 40025 item 10 have been successfully assigned to this item. The second successfully item 2 is the sales order item. Okay. So I have assigned the contract. What is that? Pricing. So let me save it. Carry the delivery. / M VL01L. Okay. Transfer order. Save data. Generate item, save, go to the delivery and carry out the PG activity. Fashion EL02N. Do the post goods issue. This is pretty favorite step. Huh? Okay. Slash NES01. Okay. It will say like POD not carried out. /MES01. I thought you would have been stuck with the Miro, but you successfully crossed the toughest part even though the easiest one. Okay. Go to this one, okay, 18,000. Out of which, I mean, this 18,000 came from two orders, okay. One sales order was created by referencing the, what you call it, by referencing our contract properly, the sales order was made. Whereas for the second order, we created the sales order without referencing the contract, but after later time, we assigned the contract to the item level. Okay, so this is how the thing works. Okay. And let us see the another contract, quantity contract. The quantity contract, the name itself suggests like you are going to make a contract for a particular quantity of the article over a period of time. So logistics, sales and distribution, sales, contract, create. The document type is QC. Enter the sold to purchase name, 29. Quantity contract. Okay, it says what is the validity, let me give from today to end of this year. Okay, material 1 to 1, 1 to 2, and 1 to 3 each. Let me see, let me put it simple, 10 pieces, so that I can show you the incompletion. 10 pieces. Here 400. Next one is also similar thing, 395, 400. Okay, so the document must be complete now. So I save the contract number 400206 slash and VA01 OR. This is the customer and quantity contract. So let me say, this is what that message is. Okay. We had, the system says like there are outline agreements existing for this material, because the system checked the header and item combination, okay, and found out like for the same combination outline agreements exist. So that is where if we had given A, which means we are getting with this proper, we have the combination of just continuing as it is or going into the branching into the list and taking up the appropriate thing. If you had chosen copy is unique, then it won't give you this pop-up also. It will automatically assign the contract to the item. And if you had chosen anything between B and E, the system will automatically list into the, it has their list. It will automatically list into the existing contract list and show you like, I choose anything from there. So I wanted to have the choice of whether taking it or not. So that is why I gave the B, that is select, I mean look into the header as well as item, and just give me a warning that so and so has been. Okay, so it has been failed. Let me go to the contract again. Slash NVA042, that is the contract. So what is the document type? It is, sorry, item category, it is KMN. I go to the item category, VOV7. See what KMN does. No problem. Go to KMN, that is quantity contract item. Let us see the completion rule. Completion rule says like, after the target quantity, full target quantity is referenced. So whereas in our document type, tell me VOV8, I'm going to look at the messages, outline messages. QC Okay, out an agreement messenger. I didn't mention anything else. So I have created a sales order. Let me process the delivery for that. So 01 M. Generate UI item. Target. Okay. So let me create a slash in email 02N. I do the PTA. Slash in email 01. Okay. Right. Invoice it. Now I'm going and seeing in the how has been it has been updated in the quantity contract. The target quantity was so and so. Okay. Is there some place you can see how much has been ordered and how much has been taken up? Okay, what is the order data? Okay, I will find out like whether we should have enabled some additional columns here or not. Well, like this is the basic difference between the quantity contract and value contract. Are you clear? Okay. What is the time there now? Is it late night? 9. Now, because I didn't hear any sound, so I thought. Okay, no problem. Okay, so go through that, go through this scenario. I don't get you. Sirisha, can you just mute that headphone for a while? Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay, it's fine. We have only two more sessions left. One session will be handling for the credit management, and one session will look into the billing plan. Okay, whether you have milestone billing, periodic billing, and other things. Okay, no problem. Okay, I will do that. Okay. Yeah, if you are there, it's okay. If you will